Third point I want to make is that hiring a new commissioner without proper advanced input starts the relationship between that commissioner and the community off on the wrong foot. And we don't wish that for any commissioner.
Well, again, you know, this part of this, the truism here is the fact that politicians have put themselves in this position by pandering over the past several years about the holistic approach, the community approach, and everything else, and doing these things. And now people have a sense of entitlement. And they think that they can change the may word to a shall. They think we may include you to you shall include us. And that actually never took place. But they have this entitlement of, but you're supposed to. No, well, I don't have to. No, I don't have to. Now that things have changed a bit, it's kind of like, whoa, you can't do this. And I think that that's quite interesting because it makes it seem as if there's, again, this sense of entitlement. And I don't know that that's the case. We seem to be getting some things lined up. Some ducks are in a row. And if we're making progress, we should be actually touting that. And how can we continue to head in a direction that appears to be the right one? That seems more important to me than anything else, right?
The next point is that the failure of the administration and the commissioner designee to reach out before and after the nomination demonstrates a blatant disregard for the important perspectives of the police accountability organizations, constitutional and human rights organizations, and community organizations. I can tell you there have been many occasions when there have been police-involved shootings and other issues in this community where we have had to reach out directly to the commissioner to de-escalate tension.
And this sounds like it's harboring some other animosities that have nothing to do with this particular process. Or here's the ring, no one kissed it. Is that part of the problem as well? Again, and this kind of confirms it.
We've gone 3 weeks now since the announcement of an acting commissioner, and we haven't heard from him. I don't have acting commissioner Worley's mobile phone number. None of our partners have heard from this acting commissioner. We were assured 3 weeks ago that the acting commissioner would be reaching out to us immediately to develop a relationship, and that didn't happen.
I mean, Baltimore is a small place, and I look at it as not a very good use of your resources if you couldn't get his number. I mean, seriously. I mean, to say that. Could have called me. I would have given it to you. You know, I would have made it happen. I'd have made that connection happen. That's kind of what I've done in my afterlife. Made connections. I don't have any involvement in it. I'll make the connection. But come on. Let's just stop. I mean, you still have a relationship with former Commissioner Harrison. He's still here. He didn't jump on a plane yet. I mean, come on. Is this really where we are? This is what they say.
As it is, we don't have a meaningful relationship with Acting Commissioner Worley. And that type of relationship has been essential to the productive engagement that we've had over the past several years with Commissioner Harrison, with former Commissioner Harrison, and the Baltimore Police Department.
I mean, 3 weeks in, going after an acting commissioner in this way is, to use a word that I hate to use often, is gross. That it's unacceptable, and I don't know that it represents the community of Baltimore City. I have certainly not heard an outcry, haven't seen it on social media, haven't heard it in the streets, haven't heard people talking about it a lot, saying, I can't believe this is what the mayor decided to do. I mean, most people, you know, had, whether it was this tone of shock or, okay, all right, good, the commissioner's gone. Most people weren't like, oh, my goodness, I can't believe the commissioner's leaving. Oh, no, they should do something to get him back. most people were kind of like, oh, wow, he's leaving. And they had an opinion, whether it was good or bad, but they were okay with it. Okay, he's leaving. And then it was like, okay, they're choosing this guy to take over. Okay, wow, he's okay, he seems to have the credentials. Okay, they actually had a plan. And I remember us talking about it here on the show. It happened at 9 o'clock in the morning. And we led into the show. It had a robust, use that word, robust conversation over 2 days about it. And it was actually great. We actually gave credit, a lot of credit, to the administration, because that was the, of all of the departures that have taken place in government, that was the one, and arguably one of the most important ones, that seemed to have a succession plan. That's the one that didn't seem to have any sort of gap, and it was arguably the most important one. And many of us, many of you commended it. And now we have the NAACP scrutinizing it and really making accusations towards the administration that the mayor, in his statement, has called inaccurate. In part, his statement read, unfortunately, at today's press conference, it appeared the Baltimore NAACP didn't have the facts. And it is incredibly disappointing that organizations who have been a critically important partners in our work to strengthen our city are taking this tack. Yeah, I mean,
tap your neighbor and say he about to say something crazy. I would love to have the NAACP stand up and saying, parents, parent. Oh, did he just say accountability again? Yes, I did. That would have been a good one. Parents, we need you to parent. We don't need no curfew. We need you to parent. We need you to make sure you know where your kids are. We don't need a public service announcement. We don't need a van busing them from east to west. We don't need a community center open at night. We need you to know where your child is. That's what we need. I don't need to go find out who the commissioner is and who what's going to be happening. I need you to know where your child is. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. Said that's what could have happened. Oh, let me see. Let me check the press release log and see if that one's coming tomorrow. Nope, not on the schedule. Oh, wow. Oh, I guess that doesn't fit the agenda. Let's go after Mayor Scott and the administration for choosing a white guy who lives in Anne Arundel County. Maybe that might be it. Oh, yep, I said it. Yep, tap your neighbor and said he said it. Yeah, he said it. And not apologizing for it, because arguably that's the biggest issue. Because in 2018, when a white police commissioner by the name of Kevin Davis was fired by then Mayor Catherine Pugh, and a black police commissioner by the name of Daryl D'Souza was appointed, we didn't have a press conference. He was appointed right away. It was done in a similar fashion. The baton wasn't a baton passing. It was just handed over. And there was no press conference. Is it a racial issue? Is that the animosity towards Commissioner Harrison? I mean, Commissioner Worley. Is that what it is? Not about credentials, not about the fact that this could be a good thing for the city moving forward, not about the continuity, not about the fact that there are less dead black and brown bodies this year than were last year. Didn't hear a word about that. Didn't hear a word about 40 less dead black and brown bodies. Didn't hear a word that Commissioner Worley is or was the deputy of operations, the one who controls what happens on the streets with the police officers. Didn't hear a word about that. Oh, yes, he did. He said it. Yep, he said it. That's right. Y'all can come to the church or not, but I said it. I'm not going to apologize for it. That's what's happening. And it's unfortunate that this is the tack. I will use the mayor's words and say it. It's unfortunate that this is the tack used in a city where our kids are not at reading at grade level. Our kids are getting killed on school grounds. Our kids are getting killed at a rate higher than many in any other city in this country. And we're having a press conference today about we weren't at the table. Man, get out of here. Tori and Dan, I'm going to get their opinion on it. They're coming up next.